20 Nerdigans, this is the one and only Packer Girl 89 of Nerdigans Inc. And today's manga Nerdigan live reaction video is going to be for chapter 54. So before I get into this recap and live reaction, let me just remind you to hit that like, share, and subscribe buttons. And because of course this channel, let alone this video, are not sponsored, and we ain't sponsored by Shueisha, and we ain't sponsored by Manga Plus, and we ain't sponsored by Viz. And considering how much we promote Manga Plus on this channel, it's kind of surprising, right? But if you love what we're doing and want to help keep this operation alive and kicking so we can keep bringing you more anime and manga content, whether it be news, analysis, or live reactions like this one, feel free to hit up our Cash App and PayPal. Links are in the description box below. So, well, our poor baby Sadame lost. He did by trying to go into Sorachika's realm. But I feel like the mission was kind of accomplished in chapter 52, with going into Fanta's amusement park and getting into, you know, his level and showing, dude, you're not alone. I've been through a similar experience and it's okay. It's time to come back to reality and face your problems. So, but anyways, it's Lucky's turn now. Let's get to chapter 54, see what's in store for us this week. And chapter 54 is titled, I Understand. Do now, Lucky. If we want to win, then this plan gives us the best chance. After I copy Fanta's playing style, you'll be up next to close the theme park. What do you think? Got any other ideas? See? What did I tell you? Sadame's mission was to close the theme park. But I think what would have helped Sadame even more is if he added his own little twist. And what I mean by that is if he himself would have appeared in the theme park with Fanta and, you know, showed him the way out, I think that would have been even more powerful, at least in my opinion. But I understand why M'Apollo didn't go that route, because it isn't any of Sadame's business. So that's why he didn't go this route. It sucks, but because I think it would have been like a really beautiful and powerful moment to have Sadame appear in the amusement park with Fanta, like his younger self. But it is what it is. I understand, though. I'm good. Let's go with that. If I give it my all, I'll hurt Fanta, and I don't want that. I might be holding back, but I really don't want him to suffer. Don't you dare take it easy. Lucky, now you're being a dick. Now you're looking down on him. See, this is why Fanta was getting pissed at Lucky. Because you were looking down on him like everyone else was. That's why Fanta was crying when Sadame was playing. Because he's like, finally someone's on my level and can understand what I've been through. Again, this is why I kind of wanted a little Sadame up in there. But anyways. All right, we're heading back to our seats. Okay, I'll play as planned. Brilliant, Lucky. I saw him wearing funeral garb. That's what I said to Sadame. But I also saw Rev within the white. It's also correct that the genius wants to live. That's something very interesting that's being mentioned here, because in The God of High School, we saw something very similar with Mubong, because Mubong was ready, well, he's trying not to die, but he was about to die, but there was these red wings that came out, and it represented the people that wanted him to live. So having this here is very, very interesting. That's right, I want to live. I've always said that, but you, the lucky on the outside, never heard me. I'm locked inside of you and I can hear your thoughts. The only time you heard me was during Sora Chica's performance. It's very interesting, isn't it? That Lucky is even kind of looking down on himself. But no, I don't want to trouble people. Because the average me was born, our family fell apart. I can't let our family stay broken and become a genius who does whatever he wants. When the siblings I love are in trouble, I need to help them through playing the piano and doing whatever else I can. But you need to embrace this part of yourself. You can't lock it away. We've seen what happens when you lock a part of yourself away. All it does is it hurts you. That's what Sora Chica was trying to tell you. Killing a part of yourself is the worst thing you can do, unless it's extremely toxic. This isn't toxic. I don't have the strength, but with everyone's support, I can help them using everything I've got. But see what I mean? He's not being selfish. That's what Sora Chica's trying to tell you, is to be selfish. You're being so stupid. We're being so... Oh, come on, man. If I were brilliant, Lucky, I wouldn't have been able to play Going Home for Reichiro or the Joyful Island for Mimin. Well, brilliant Lucky's been inside you this whole time. If you were brilliant, if you just embraced him and were one and the same, you could have helped them even more. I was influenced by brilliant Lucky and went with the plan that I'll hurt Fanta. Oh my god, Lucky. No! You don't know that it'll hurt Fanta. Have you thought that the other side of the coin, that it might actually help him? He needs to face reality. He can't be stuck in this fantasy forever. That's why when we saw him a couple of chapters ago, he was crying and you saw a smile on his face because he needed to hear it. You can't stay in this fantasy world. You can't have all this positivity all the time. People need to face reality. That's right. I wouldn't have played Going Home or the Joyful Island. And that's true for Fanta as well. If something important is at stake, I don't care who gets hurt. I don't care about the whole thing with Mom. If Fanta doesn't want to see her, that's fine. Fanta and Mom are important. I want to find a way for them to be happy. And for Don and Sakato and Sora Chica too. I want them to be happy no matter what. Brilliant Lucky can't do it. He's too self-centered and cruel. Kind people are unnecessary. That's because kind acts can be done by anyone. Ooh, that is very true. Even I've had someone thank me for being kind, but I only said what I was thinking. And I've experienced kindness. I may be alone here, but that one listens to me. I thought the child's sound who spoke to me was kind. Your kindness is too light, too cheap, an afterthought, a mere formality, not real presumptuous. Ooh. Nonetheless, Mimin's free spirit conveniently comprehended that cheap kindness as she attained freedom. Lucky, I love you. I love everything. As for Reichiro, he hates being alone, so he's susceptible to cheap kindness. Fanta rejected it. He doesn't believe in cheap kindness. As for Sora Chica, I bet he'll hate it a lot. Kind to the ears, a kind sound. I wish he would stop doing things that child doesn't like. See, Sora Chica, I understand why he mentioned Sora Chica. Sora Chica's the only one that could really hear him. And Sora Chica is the only one that could see through Lucky's superficiality. Because... what Lucky is doing is, in a way, very superficial. And I'm not gonna lie, it kind of makes me think of Sherry's Love is 8 Meters. Because a week ago, we saw her doing all these heroic acts. And what she said to Yumi was, I'm not doing it for them. Nah, I'm doing it because I want to do it for myself. I know it's very selfish, right? Lucky, you shouldn't be doing it because of other people. You should be doing it because you want to do it for yourself. You want to do it because you love playing the piano. Yes, there's the other thing with the siblings, sure, but your love for the piano should come first. Oh, look at him. That spotlight, huh? What? There's never been a spotlight here before. Maybe I've been chosen. Huh? I get it. Next up for the 4-on-4 final battle. Alright, I'm gonna play for Fonta and for the audience. I'm playing for them. I'm playing the piano I love so much. I've always played to make others happy. The piano is a tool I love and use to please others. Actually, I want to continue with our plan, but I want Fonta to be happy too. Hey, what's the plan? Can you tell me now? Well, first I evoke the theme park's closing parade, then after that, Lucky takes everyone home by train. And it's not just a normal train ride at each station. The audience can re-experience the best moment they had in college. Ooh, that's actually smart. Does each person have a unique experience like Sora Chika Odagami? That's the idea. Lucky was preparing a different experience for everybody. First there's the image of graduation, then the thought of never coming back. Combine that with the sadness of leaving the theme park. The audience won't feel like enjoying the theme park anymore, besides it's closed. The plan is to close the park. They've come up with a plan that's as petty as I am, as if it's nothing. Not like I'm in a position to say anything. Ooh, there's Fonta. Here we go. But, dude, Lucky getting called out for his superficial kindness by his inner self. But now his brilliant self has been summoned. Now this will be interesting to see what happens. Because, let's be real, Lucky is being a hypocrite himself. Because he wants to do all this shit for Fonta and bring Fonta back into reality when Lucky, and I just realized this, Lucky's in a fantasy world of his own. And he needs to be brought back to reality. If you think about it. Hopefully this means Lucky's going to embrace him. I love this line, though. But yeah, it was only Sora Chika that really gave the brilliant Lucky any kindness. It's so sad. But I love this. I love this line so much. Kind people are unnecessary. That's because kind acts can be done by anyone. Even I've had someone thank me for being kind, but I only said that what I was thinking, and I've experienced kindness. I may be alone here, but that one listens to me. I thought the child's son was, who spoke to me was kind. Your kindness is too light, too cheap, an afterthought, a mere formality, not real, presumptuous. I want to be kind to my siblings. I want them to live happily. I really don't want him to suffer. Nonetheless, Mimin's free spirit conveniently comprehended that cheap kindness as she attained freedom. As for Reijiro, he hates being alone, so he's susceptible to cheap kindness. Fonta rejected it. He doesn't believe in cheap kindness. As for Sora Chika, I bet he'll hate it a lot. I understand. Fonta doesn't tolerate that fuckery, because Fonta's been through that fuckery for, you know, a good chunk of his life. He sees through the bullshit. Same with Sora Chika. Sora Chika and Fonta see through the bullshit. While Mimin and Reijiro, you know, they're very innocent. And what this tells me is, whew, especially with Fonta, Fonta's been having it rough. He really's been through the fuckery. Mm-hmm. I really love what Emma Paulo's doing here. I really like the plan that they have, though, for Fonta. I do. And remember what Sora Chika said to Lucky even prior to playing La Capanella? It makes so much sense now. It does. I really like the direction M. Apollo is going with this, because it's not. Everything has been leading in regards to, like, La Campanella in particular. It's been leading to this moment. It's a very therapeutic moment, not just for Fanta, but for Lucky as well, where they are truly liberating themselves from their own fantasy worlds. Where Lucky, it was superficial kindness, and Fanta, it was literally escapism from all the trauma that he had endured. It's very brilliant, actually. They are two sides of the same coin. And both of them, I really like what he's doing because both are very relatable. Because people do put on a superficial face, like Lucky, for to be kind to people. The superficial kindness, it's expected of people. And this is both in Japan and in the US and in the West. It's expected of people, whether via wokeness or otherwise. And in regards to Fanta, I mean, if you've ever been through trauma, if you've ever been depressed, I mean, you have to have a mask and cover it up. You have, because no one's going, like, you feel like no one's going to save you but yourself. So. But also, I'm going to point this out, both of them also have this other underlying theme where there's always that one person that can see through all the bullshit. Where, and both of them, you can make the argument that it was Sora Chica, but in this case, in this scenario, it is, Sora Chica didn't bring Fanta back, even though Sora Chica could somewhat relate to it, but, well, in terms of skill, but emotionally, he could not relate to it, whereas Sadame could. See what I mean? So that's why what M. Apollo was doing here is so brilliant. How each round is bringing out something in their competitor, minus the final one, or La Campanella, where it got a little bit more complex, and it's bringing out something. It's bringing out the final person, with Lucky and Fanta, out of their fantasy world. It's very interesting, and I really like it. It's very powerful. I really hope more people are reading this manga. This manga is very underrated, at least in my opinion. Because, at least in the West, because I know this manga sells pretty decently in Japan, but in the West, because there's this mentality that, and I blame Viz for it especially, that manga, well, you can blame anime for this too, that manga is basically like Battle Shonen and all that shit. That this manga gets overlooked because of it. So, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what you guys think of this chapter. What do you guys think of, like, the underlying themes that's going on here between Lucky and Fanta, that they're both in their own fantasy world for different reasons, and that the kindness was superficial? I really love it. I love it so much. I love that everything has been connected with Sora Chica in regards to Lucky. I love that everything for Fanta has been connected to Sadame. I think, everything with the, and how everything with La Campanella, again, with La Campanella, how much more complex each person, their opponent is, brought out the more complex sides of their opponent. I think it's very, very interesting in how different it is, sure, but it's still very interesting nonetheless. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what you guys think. And remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe to Nerdigans Inc. Love what we're doing. I want to help keep this operation alive and kicking so we can keep bringing you more PPPPPPPP content. A few ways you could do that: donate to our Cash App, PayPal, Patreon, purchase something off our Amazon wishlist, all that's in the description box below. Also, make sure you follow us on Twitter, Twitch, Discord, friend us on PlayStation Network, that's in the description box below as well. Till next time, Nerdigans, I will be seeing you later. Bye!